Mambo Italiano, go, go, go. You mixed up Siciliano, all you Calabrese do the mambo like a crazy with a hey, mambo. Don't want a tarantella, hey, mambo. No more the mozzarella, hey, mambo. Mambo Italiano, try an enchilada with the fish baccalà. And hey, gumba, I love how you dance, rumba.
I'd like to just show you what fresh basil looks like cut right off the plant and what basil looks like after a couple days of hanging. So you see, I have it like this. So there's two different ways that you could do this. So you could see that it's already drying out. But if you don't want to wait for it to dry out naturally, you can bake it low on the oven, and I'll show you that step next. Heat the oven to 180. When it's ready, we'll put it in. So right now I'm just pulling the leaves, the basil leaves off the plant. You can see it's quite large. I'm gonna do this so I fill up the tray. I'm probably gonna have to do this twice, actually, with all the basil that I have here. And then I'll be back after it's full. I have two trays ready. They shouldn't touch too much because it takes them longer to dry out then. But sadly, this won't make very much, and you'll see at the end. Update, this is after 30 minutes in the oven. You see that the leaves are drying out and shrinking. So for parsley, I'm breaking off the leaf from the stem. That's just gonna save you some work later on. And as soon as the basil is done, then I will throw these in the oven as well. So I've prepped the parsley on the tray, and when I laid it out, I looked for any stems that I might have missed. And I'm gonna put it in the oven for 35 minutes. Along with the basil that I combined to one tray from the two. So this is oregano, and oregano has a much harder stem, so you gotta be careful to get this off. And it actually comes off pretty easy if you pull down. I'll do another piece to show. Now I haven't washed this yet, but I'll do that as soon as I'm done. I wanted to get it all off the plant stems first. So you can see how this is looking inside here. So you see I'm pulling against the leaves to get this off. It smells absolutely amazing. So we'll see what the difference is between dried in the oven herbs and the ones that are hanging to dry like they used to do in the old country. The oregano is ready to go in. So the parsley is now finished. You can hear how it sounds, and it stays very green. The oregano is also finished, very small. And I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna put them in a bag, and then I will crunch them.
this just came out of the oven, and you can see how dry it is. I'm going to put it inside a bag, and I'm going to crunch it. And then I will put it inside of a storage container. Just let you hear what that looks like. And you see it's becoming small pieces. And then, voila! Ready to put in your sauce, your favorite Italian meals, and it's good to go. So here is the parsley and oregano in the bags. I wanted to show you how it looks if you wanted to hang and dry your herbs naturally. So this is parsley. This is basil. It has a 2-day advance compared to that one. And this is oregano. This is the basil after 6 days. You can hear that it's getting really crunchy. Will probably take about 2 weeks, maybe even less, to dry out. The parsley is still quite soft. I can imagine this is for sure gonna take 2 weeks. So this is after 4 days versus 6 days for the basil. And the oregano is already getting quite dry, so I'm thinking only a week or more for that. And if you wanted to use these right away, you would just take them, put them over your saucepan and just squeeze it, and the pieces will fall right into whatever you're cooking. Just wanted to show you what my basil looked like after I cut it completely off almost. It came back. Parsley as well.